Emergency rooms while they wait 5 and 6 hours to see a specialist. We have shortages of engineers and architects and in the trades, mechanics and other working people. Meanwhile, we prevent the very immigrants we brought here from doing those jobs because of regulatory gatekeepers. So what are we going to do? The Poilievre government will incentivize the provinces through immigrants transfer funds to ensure that within 60 days of a newcomer applying to work in their trade or profession, they get a yes or no answer. And if they are not able to get a yes, they should get a path to licensure and they should get a small study loan to help them get qualified so that we can remove the gatekeepers and put people to work. I hear somebody yelling, stop the pipeline. I think, you want to stop the pipeline, sir? What do you want, Saudi Arabia to send their oil over here? Is that your answer? Yeah, I think you're wrong, sir. We need to use Canadian energy, not foreign energy. We're not stopping the pipeline, we're going to build more pipelines. We need to open the gates of opportunity for all Canadians. And you know, speaking of shouting people down, aren't we going to put an end to this outrageous, politically correct woke culture that is all about, right? The real purpose is not about social justice.
Nope.
It's about dividing people.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
They want to divide people based on race and ethnicity and sexuality and now vaccine status.
Yeah.
Now by next year, they will have thought of some other artificial dividing line to turn people against each other. Now this is particularly ironic coming from our current Prime Minister, who has an ugly racist past of his own for which he has never fully come to account. But he still divides people along racial lines. So why do they do this? Ladies and gentlemen, it's the oldest trick in the book. Divide and conquer, right? If the government can make you afraid of your neighbor, turn you against your truck driver, get you fighting with your coworker, they think that they can force you to turn to the government and give them more power, right? And so this is what they're doing. They're now bringing in legislation, C-11, which would give the CRTC the power to determine what you see and say online. And it's worse than that. And it is worse than that. They even have this proposal for something called a digital harm commissioner.
What?
Did we read about this in Orwell's 1984?
Yeah.
A digital harm commissioner? Who would this guy even be? He's going on the internet looking for ideas that he might think are going to be harmful. We're not talking about criminal activity. Everything that's criminal in the tangible world is already criminal on the internet. We're talking about things that the government deems that it finds harmful to its interests. Ladies and gentlemen, let me tell you, if they ever do establish this digital harms commissioner, I can guarantee you one thing. On the first day I'm Prime Minister, he will be an unemployed digital harms commissioner. Censorial CC11 will get rid of all of the efforts by the government to censor what we see and say online and will speak out strongly in favor of academic freedom at our university campuses as well. Instead of dividing and conquering, what about uniting for freedom?
Yeah!
The great thing, this is the wonderful thing about freedom. This is the difference between freedom and power, okay? okay? Let's talk about this for a second. Because a lot of people say, Pierre, if you're a leader, can you take power? I don't want to take power. I'm running to give power back to the people. You see, power is a zero-sum game. If one person has more power, someone else has less, right? There can only be 100% of the power. And government basically divides up that power, and that's why it causes so much division. Freedom, by contrast, is exactly the opposite. If your neighbor has more freedom, it means you probably have more freedom, not less, right? It is an infinite resource, and that is why it is a unifying resource. Has more freedom to make decisions for themselves, it probably means their neighbor has more freedom as well. And so if we unite around that principle, we can actually bring our people back together again. Wouldn't you like to be in a country where we could actually talk to each other and embrace each other and be fellow Canadians regardless of race or sexuality? My friends, freedom has always come from the bottom up, never from the top down. Our tradition of freedom here in Canada goes back 800 years to the year 1215, yep, when the commoners forced King John to sign the Great Charter, and they did it out in the fields of Runnymede, right? That's why the House of Commons is actually green. It's green because the first commoners were in the fields. It was not the royalty that brought freedom from above. It was the people that forced it from below. They forced King John to kneel down and sign that Great Charter and give the power back to the people, right? So that's our tradition. And what does this mean for you? It means you have to take back control of your life. I can't do it for you. I will do it alongside with you. You have to be a member of the Conservative Party if you want to vote in the leadership race. If you want me to be your Prime Minister, I must first be your leader, which means you have to have a membership in the Conservative Party. And that means you have to be a member of the party if you want to vote as well. Get your membership if you want to vote. Because, ladies and gentlemen, freedom is a contract between the dead, the living, and the yet to be born.
Yeah.
Right?
That's right.
It is the duty of every living generation to pass it down. It might be 800 years long, this history, but it is only one generation deep. This is our duty as this generation to take back control of our lives, to make Canada the freest nation on earth. And in the words of the great Prime Minister, the great Western Canadian, John Diefenbaker. Who said, yeah, that's right, Diefenbaker. You know what I'm going to say. Yeah. I am a Canadian, a free Canadian, free to speak without fear, free to stand for what I think right, free to oppose what I believe wrong, free to worship God in my own way, free to choose those who should have.
So I want you all to line up over there.